So you were saying Odin was lonely? That's why he was always at war?
Nothing quite so simple. But I hoped that love might temper him and give us a chance for peace. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity. Arcane runes. Perhaps we're meant to find something in Muspelheim and Niflheim.
Okay. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Freya end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. Or I can just tell you this story later.
We're not getting in there without a key. Come here. You were telling us how Freya ended up living in the woods.
Aye, she'd married Odin. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities, and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh. Like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Here, boy.
What are you doing?
Thank you.
you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the giants?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giant kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, when victory was still a thing dreamed of and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Let's pick this up later, then.
I still can't believe a son would kill his own father. That's crazy, right? I know, he only got one side of the story. But come on, his own father? I mean, I get angry at you sometimes, but...
Do you?
I mean, sometimes, yeah. A little. But I'd never stab you in the back.
No. But...
This clan really didn't want anyone coming in. How are we supposed to get through?
There must be a way to lift the gate.
Maybe with the big water wheel.
My thought as well.
solves that treasure map.
When are you angry?
What?
With me. When?
Oh. I guess... sometimes when you don't think I can do something, but I can.
It is not always easy to know what...
It's okay. I get it. I'm little. Where's that watchstone, I wonder?
This is the sun.
That ghost sun? How do you know?
The sigil. It matches the dagger we found in his father's back. He stood his ground, but it was not enough.
They betrayed him.
Betrayal begets betrayal. My guess, the young one murdering his dad didn't sit well with the others.
He thought himself ready to lead. It cost him his life.
I guess.
Look there, lad. By his feet.
The whetstone!
Yes. They used it to smash his face in.
They did? Ew.
Have very specific priorities. If it's not shiny and you can't eat or drink it, might as well use it as a blunt object.
Boy.
Sir. There's a scroll here. It belonged to the sun. Wow. This goes on and on. Father, forgive me. Filled with remorse. Forget my actions.
Had you thought before taking action, there would be no need for regret, yes?
Yeah. Maybe we should bring this to his father. Back at the storeroom.
Go! Boy.
Yes, sir. This says, false leader. I've seen it written all over this place. Why was Tyr helping Odin meet with the Giant Kings?
Well, I can just tell you the story later.
How did it go with the Strong?
We found your whetstone.
Oh!
The Reavers, you...
Oh.
I can't wait to test out the new whetstone. It may not look...